Hey y'all, Surfing Sapa here. Today's November 1st, 2017. I got this cookbook that I bought a long time ago. Cajun Men Cook. Recipes, stories, food experiences from Louisiana Cajun country. It's pretty cool, man. It's got a lot of stories and history in here and where a lot of the recipes came from. But today I'm making one. It's called Boeuf EN Daube. It's beef with vegetables. It's kind of like a pot roast kind of thing with the onions, carrots, and beef. But you'll see, it's interesting. Nonetheless, I'm gonna go right out of the cookbook, okay? So if anybody has a problem with this video, you need to talk to the folks that wrote this cookbook. I'm just following directions, folks. Let's get started. First thing it says is cut steak into 1/2-inch cubes. Roll in flour, salt, and pepper. Ta-da, already did that. Okay, now we're gonna take some bacon, 6 pieces, and we're gonna throw it into a heavy skillet. I'm gonna put it in there. That's my heavy skillet. I was gonna cook everything in that, but I'm not. So, let's take some bacon. Lay it in there. I don't know if 6 pieces will fit, but hopefully it will. Come on, boy, heat up. That's 4 or 5. We'll make it fit. It's going to shrink no how. This is HEB bacon. Nothing special, but it's good bacon. I guess that's special, right? Anyway, put them in there, let them cook. While that's going on, I'm gonna read to you and I'm gonna talk a little bit. All right, we got the beef here. This is a, what is it? It's round steak, 2 pounds of round steak cut into pieces about that big right there. Just coated with flour like when you brown stew meat. Then back over here, I got 2 large onions quartered and then 6 carrots. And we're gonna put alcoholic beverages in it today. 2 different kinds. Now, this recipe calls for cloves, and I don't see anywhere in there in the instructions where you use the cloves, so I'm just gonna throw the cloves into the stew while it's cooking in the oven. Okay, let's see what we've got on our bacon now. If this takes a long time, so be it. I don't care, I haven't made a video for a while, so bear with me. Shouldn't take too long. Yeah, it's cooking. Come on, boys. Come on, fellas, release that fat. That fat's our friend. So, let's see. I'm gonna cut and I'm gonna come back when that's done, because from there it goes real fast, okay? Okay, let's take our bacon out. Take it out before it's done. Throw it over there in the other cast iron vessel. We're gonna call it a vessel. It's a Dutch oven, pretty much. Put it up in there. Now we have our, we've got our oil up in here now, okay? So, let's do JB style. And zoom in a bit, okay? All right, now we're gonna take the beef and drop them in this oil. Let them brown. Oh, I'm just gonna do it by hand. Some of the stuff came off, but not too bad. I'm just wondering if I'm gonna need more oil. Hopefully not. They're real sticky. I don't wanna just throw them in there, cause they'll just stick to each other and they're not gonna cook. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying, y'all? At least this way they're gonna cook. Somewhat. Okay. So we'll brown all those. See what we got here. So these first ones look. Nope. Gotta get hotter. Gotta fry, baby. I might have to add some olive oil. I don't know how they do it. These cooks, they're magnifico. They're real good. Yeah, it's kind of browny. Okay. That's not quite half of it, so we'll just do this bit. Oh, almost forgot. Well, that's cooking. Let's turn our attention over here. This is supposed to be cut into 1-inch pieces and laid on the bottom of this vessel. So let's just do that while we're, well, that's cooking. Approximately 1 inch. You just lay them on the bottom. No biggie. It's all gonna get to know each other, know how, you know what I'm saying? Get up. You just layer this on the bottom. Man, bacon, yum. The house smells really nice right now. Just lay them something like that. Get everybody, make it. There could be gaps, I guess. I'm just trying to get it the best you can. That's good enough, okay? All right, now let's go back over here. Okay, let's see what we got. We don't want to burn these either, but we want to brown them. Brown, baby? Yeah? A little bit, good enough. Flavor, just flour. Flour and bacon fat. Meat cooking and bacon fat. There we go. Hopefully I won't get tagged in the stupid commercial. Let me shut that off, folks. That's aggravating, whatever that is. Well, it's a lady cooking. I got on YouTube watching some French cooks so I could get ideas on if I'm doing this right. Well, let me brown all these up. Or actually, I'll take you in when I get them browned up and put them in the other pot, okay? This is wine, 1 cup of wine and 1 cup of beef stock. We're pouring it into this where we brown the meat to get the all the stuff off the bottom. And bring it to a boil. Get you something like this. I'm using this roux scraper. And just scrape it. And it'll start releasing. But while we're bringing that to a boil, let's get some entertainment going, okay? We need entertainment in our life, don't we, folks? Okay, so we're going to go over here now. Take a look right here. We're going to take, voila, brandy. We're going to pour it into a shot glass so we get about a shot. This is bigger than a shot glass, so I didn't fill it up. Okay, this is starting to boil now, so I'll just bring you back to that in a minute. But right here, we need to sprinkle this all over the meat as such. Brandy, okay? Alcohol. Then I got my trusty lighter here. There, see that? You let it catch on fire. It doesn't last long, apparently. Dang. Nope. I guess that's all. That's all she wrote. It doesn't last long. All right. Wasn't that entertaining, was it? Back here. You can feel it releasing now. The bottom of the pot is becoming smooth. This is just dry white wine. Okay. Now I got to get some gloves or something because this sucker's hot. We're getting close to the end. Not the end of prepping. It's one heck of a recipe, man. So back off. I'll turn you all around this way. Okay, let me get some gloves. We're gonna pour that, or pot holders, whatever. We're just gonna simply take the contents of this over here and just pour it in there. Don't be afraid. Just pour it in. Try to get it on all the meat. It's all gonna get to know each other anyway. Get this out of here. It's hot. Yeah. Put it right there. All right. I guess we can bring this over here now. Ugh, come here, boy. This isn't really hot, so I didn't need to do that. All right. Now we're gonna zoom in on this baby. Whoop. Okay. Right there. All right. Let me look at my thing here. All right. Adding our veggies. Carrots. 6 carrots peeled and cut up. I do have a Facebook page, I hope you know. Cooking with Surf and Sapo, so search for it because I would like you all to go there. I post a lot of the stuff that I cook there also that I don't make videos of. Quartered onions. Like that. And then the little pieces that fell out. Okay. All right. Some thyme, I don't know how much, just throw it in there, it'll be all right. I think it's gonna, the steam is gonna circulate everything. Some red pepper. About a quarter of a teaspoon, I think. Something like that, that's good. And like I said, it calls for these cloves, 3 of them. But I don't see where they put it in, so I'm just gonna drop them in there. I guess it, cloves are strong, you know. It'll probably mix with the wine and everything and then just totally go everywhere. And another 1/2 cup of wine, it says. So we're gonna put our wine, this is a cup, so we'll just guesstimate about that much right there, okay? And just pour it around. So far we've put in 1/2 cup of beef stock, 1/2 cup of wine, and then another, oh, maybe it says 1 cup of wine. Let me see. Yeah, 1 cup. I'm sorry. I got to put some more. 1 cup. What was I thinking? You can't OD on wine. It's good for you. There we go. All right, that's enough. I'll save this for me, so I have something for the chef. Okay, pretty much that's it that I could tell. I could add a little salt, I guess. But we can do that later. Let's add a little pepper, for good measure. We will add some salt for good measure, folks. We always want good measure. That's enough. This thing puts out a lot. Okay, I think that's it. So now what we do, put this, ooh, it's hot. Put that on top. And I put this in the oven for 2 hours at 300 degrees. So when that's done, we'll be back. Well, it's been 2 hours now. And I actually took this out a little while earlier to let it rest. See all the steam coming off? Well, there it is. And it looks beautiful. So, let's get something like this and try not to make a mess. This isn't hot anymore. Get some onion. Oh, and also, right here, I got some potatoes. And while the oven was hot, I went ahead and wrapped them in foil and made a baked potato to lay in here with it. Let's get more onion. We love onion. Carrot. Some carrots and some beef. Whoop. Oh boy. This smells wonderful. The recipe, Boeuf EN Daube, it means beef stew, okay? So this is beef stew, more or less. That's good enough for now. I'll save some for my wife. Now, let's take a look at this. Beef stew, French style, from page 165 of the Cajun Men Can Cook Cookbook. It's very beautiful. Everything's tender. Just cuts like that. Look at the meat. Well, I better make sure. Well, the meat's a little bit. No, it's not. I don't know. It is what it is. There. It cuts. See? This is a spoon. Everything's soft. Onions, they're soft. Look at that. So, let's let it cool a bit and we'll do a taste test. All right, we're done. It's rested. And let's try it out. Get a carrot. Nice and sweet. A little bit of onion. Nothing like a baked onion, folks. Some meat. It has an awesome flavor, but I think the cut that I bought, a round steak, is cheap. And it's maybe it needs to cook a little more, I don't know. But the vegetables are ready, so it's good. It's just a little bit chewy, but the gravy's killer. The flavor's phenomenal. Yum. Potato. Not much to that, but it's good with the gravy. Wow. That's good. Let me get the cookbook. You can, you don't have to use, I got it out of this cookbook here, okay? It's called Cajun Men Cook, Recipe Stories, Food Experiences from Louisiana Cajun Country. The reason I got it out of this was that I have a cookbook and I might as well use the darn thing. And when people watch this video and they start critiquing or whatever you want to call it, say, hey man, I followed the directions, so, you know, go argue with the author, which it's about 30 men that live in the area of Lafayette. Anyway, Boeuf EN Daube, very, very good, highly recommended. You can Google it, but almost all of the videos on YouTube are French, most of them. And I'll tell you what, I just let it play, a playlist of the French videos. Oh man, you talk about good food, folks. Wow. So, with that being said, thanks for watching. I hope you try this. It's just more or less another version of beef stew, okay, in French. They saw something. Give it a whirl. It's the right weather. Well, it was last week. It's 90 again. And I got a cold. I'm sick, so hope I get well soon. I don't like being sick. And thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time. God bless you. Leave some comments, and I'll get back to you when I get back to you. Okay, folks? Thanks for being good friends. Adios. Goodbye. Auf Wiedersehen. And all that good stuff.